Alright, we'll make back to our friend now. It's like, where the hell did you go for the last 20 minutes? We pick up the pace a little bit. What's this?
There's no way David would get in Mrs. Grant's face. She'd shut his ass down fast.
From David Manson. Dear Ms. Michelle Grant, as head of security at Blackwell Academy, it's my job and duty to make sure all the bases have been covered when it comes to protecting the student body. Who's Michelle Grant? I know I'm nobody's favorite among the faculty and students, but I know I'm making sure their safety is my prime directive. Since taking over as head of security, my statistics speak for themselves, as does the 15.4% drop in campus crime. I respect your position as a science teacher, but you have unfairly Ms. Grant. Okay. You have unfairly demonized my plans for a surveillance system with a cowardly petition. I hope you will redact this petition and reconsider the human cost of not retrofitting Blackwell Academy with the latest in safe and private security. They don't need cameras all over, they just need an alarm.
Only a total phony would wear a crappy hat like that.
Whose hat? A hunting hat. You know, it's funny, I almost thought it was Clementine's hat from the Walking Dead Telltale games. It'd be cool if they threw that in just as a funny, you know, aside. I'm sure many people have played the same, you know, kind of game. What is that? Outfits? Some magazine or something? Having some trouble over there?
That's it. What the fuck? The security officer should have the key to the principal's office.
He's hiding shit, like everybody here.
Well, now we definitely have to get this door open.
Pick it?
Believe it or not, I know a little about lockpicking, thanks to Frank. I might as well test out my thief skill.
Go for it. We're already in this deep.
Well, you could look for the key, just in case.
Why, yes, I could.
I didn't see a drawer or anything anywhere. Like these now? Yeah, these show up now.
Nothing here. Dead end.
Dead endo.
Boring. Crap.
Boring crap. Key rack. Well, that would make sense. Let's see if there's anything else to be had.
No keys here.
I like to squeeze every bit out of a game, if you haven't noticed, guys. Let me just check here for a sec. I know what's in the key rack. Pigeonholes?
Nothing here. No key for thee. We have to find another way in.
Is this some...
I spent enough time with Frank.
I saw someone...
But I'll use my DIY lockpick tools while you come up with a better plan.
My plan has a name.
I saw someone walking.
Hey, Warren. You busy?
I know where the keys are. I was
just
looking everywhere.
Her. You'll be okay.
God.
Listen, I need your physics expertise stat. Without naming names, if somebody had access to the art and science labs and wanted to construct a device that would, say, open a locked door, would you maybe kind of know how? Huh? No. I'm just asking for fun. Thanks, science guy. No. Stay. We need you as backup. Just send the text instructions now. Yes, I'm still all in to go ape with you at the drive-in. Thanks for the help.
I know where the key rack is.
This sucks ass. Goddamn door. Try not to wake up everybody at Blackwell.
Sorry, Max. I got nothing. What about your plan?
I'm gonna go put it together. Can you stay here and not get caught?
I might get on the other side of that door before you, Lupin.
Lupin?
The race is on. See you soon.
The text is thinking about soda? Now pay attention, 007. You have to find four objects. Sugar, a soda can, duct tape, and sodium chlorate. Well, we know this is going to be in the science classroom. Here's how you'll do it. Any questions? Sodium chlor, WTF? It's just a powder used to create chlorine dioxide. Shit, everybody knows that. So you're really going to try this? Keyword is try. I bow to your wisdom. Oh boy, this is advanced stuff. Sugar. We're going to blow up the door? Or blow the lock? So we got two here. There's a key rack over here. I'm guessing there's nothing in here either, then.
Here are the keys. None for the principal's office.
Okay. Okie doke. Gotta go find lots of stuff. Oh, sugar.
Ooh, sugar.
Sugar, sugar. Dun, 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 dun.
Only three more items to go.
Soda from the vending machine.
Warren is such a classic nerd. Let's see if I can find those items.
Do we have some change?
Release the crack can.
The crack can.
It's all mine anyway. You're halfway home, Max.
You still there? Did you blow up? Max? Still here, didn't blow up, not yet. I need to concentrate now. TTYL, talk to you later. Oh, that's not a door. See how he distracts us?
Gross. I hate that formalin smell.
Science book.
So, sodium chlorate is a weed killer. You'd think Warren would have told me that factoid.
Huh. These are little supplies here. Weed killer. There's chemistry stuff there too.
Here's the sodium chlorate box. You're an artist, damn it, not a scientist. But this is so not sodium chlorate. Here's the sodium chlorate box.
Oh. I thought everything else had just take, not look.
You know you're clumsy, Max. Don't waste your rewind power. Use the damn chair.
Huh. You know you're clumsy. Thanks, game.
Only one more ingredient left.
Which is... duct tape. Where could we most likely find duct tape? This guy is very helpful, isn't he? Pretty useful. Well, I'm guessing in another room. Why else would we be able to go in this room if it didn't
have- This is like a scene in a horror film.
If it didn't have- I don't know why they'd have duct tape, but... Watch this be a very difficult item, the last item. So many games I play that- oh! Nope.
The tape is mine.
You got.
Now it's time to show Chloe that Max is the bomb.
The bomb. Open door, please. Oh, we can run now. It's letting us run. Because the game knows that we're walking back and forth to get all this crap.
So, Nada.
Got it.
Take it easy on the door, Chloe. Let's try this instead. Boom! Literally.
Yes! I'm trying to kick it open.
Blow shit up! If you'll light the candle. This is so cool!
This work in real life?
Get ready to haul ass.
People might hear this from outside. Just saying.
That was so fucking cool! Oh, we are toast! Here comes the whole Arcadia Bay Fire and Police Department! So what should we do?
Run in there and see what we can get. What are we trying to get?
I must have missed something. I should rewind.
We must have tripped the fire alarm. Apparently there is no burglary alarm in this place. We're in the room. Although we didn't do anything to get in here. Look at that sparkle, sparkle. See those sparkling? I guess once we let Chloe in here, we can actually interact with this stuff.
This ancient door is no match for Max the Magician.
Well, no, because we're on the other side of it where the lock is. Ta-da!
This bastard opens, she can't cheat with her rewind. Oh, this is bullshit! Fuck you, door!
Welcome to my domain. You are magic!
That's awesome.
I have no clue how the hell you got in there, but you did it, sister.
You blew it
the
up.
Company I keep. Now, let's find what we want and beat it. My powers only go so far.
Man, I can see why the principal locks this room up. Fancy faux art crap. He must want everybody to know he has money, but no taste.
How can you trust somebody who has a fucking bronze bird in his office?
I'm glad I was expelled.
Yes, if Excuse only me. The principal had a Monet or Picasso, you'd still be at Blackwell.
Eat me. I'm gonna pilfer the papers on this ugly-ass desk. Okay, sure. It's ugly, but damn, is it a cozy chair.
Don't get too comfortable.
This is your chance to truly get all deductive and shit, Sherlock. Find us some clues about Rachel, or Kate, or Nathan. Anybody.
Yeah, I'm just waiting for the cutscene to go past, you know. Okay, now I can do. Ooh. Holy frame rate hit. So did you blow the lock, Unabomber? Oh, please, I wanted to see if you knew your explosives and to see your incredible artwork. So cool to stalk the halls when it's dark and quiet. Even with so many terrible things happening all around us, it felt like Chloe and I were walking towards the center of a great cosmic mystery, something bigger than any of us. But we kind of suck as master spies, so we didn't have a key for the principal's office. No worries with my rewind power at hand. And of course, Dr. Warren Graham. He came through with a bitchin' mini-bomb made of sodium... what the hell ever. I probably learned more putting those ingredients together than the entire semester so far. Sorry, Miss Grant. Warren is the star student here. He tries so hard to help. Maybe too much, but what's wrong with that these days? I'm so grateful he's on my team. Now, it's funny with that puzzle. I thought we were going to actually have to mix the ingredients and all this stuff. All I had to do was gather four things, and the game did the rest, so... This definitely is not your average adventure game.
Wowzer. This will so not come in handy.
A whiskey bottle over there.
You're not so tacky up close. Dude, I know I shouldn't be going through the principal's files, but it's kind of cool.
Revenge on Blackwell.
Now's your chance to get revenge on Blackwell.
Oh yeah, I'm so bummed I don't get to party with the Vortex Club.
There's still time.
Especially with you around, right?
Don't talk. Search.
Oh, I like it when you get bossy. You're finally learning from the master.
We're the one who started talking to her.
I'd drink too if I was the principal of Blackwell.
Hidden in the corner, huh?
And nothing here. Rachel doesn't seem so troubled based on all this. But there's not much here about the police investigation.
Unfortunately, Rachel Amber has stopped attending class for the past month, and she's left no contact with students or faculty for the past month. Her parents are at the present unaware of her whereabouts, and Blackwell hopes for her quick return to continue her academic excellence. Rachel Amber is the quintessential student representation of Blackwell Academy. She excels in all of her studies and extracurricular activities, which are numerous. Popular with both students and faculty, she has the de facto qualities of scholarship and leadership that is a hallmark of Blackwell's legacy. Her diverse goals include a career in international law and fashion modeling. There is no doubt that Rachel will achieve all of her dreams with Blackwell as the fulcrum. Principal Wells, this is Lieutenant Chris Rossi. Just wanted to let you know that Rachel Amber's investigation has officially been closed on our end. We always hope for that one magic clue, but once again, Arcadia Bay covers up another secret. We always keep our eyes and ears open, but that's all we can do for now. Thanks for all your help.
Man, I don't blame the principal for expelling Chloe. Bad Chloe.
Chloe Price is a problematic student at Blackwell, despite the best efforts of the faculty and administration to guide her academically. Chloe does little homework and is often willfully belligerent to her teachers. She has caused numerous class disruptions with inappropriate comments and rude gestures to fellow students. She was recently suspended for spray painting graffiti in the parking lot. Even though Chloe is an intelligent student with potential, she chooses to squander it on empty rebellion against a non-mandatory institution. Chloe Price is no longer a student at Blackwell. See attached police reports.
Only two more files to go.
Two more files to find? I guess so. Oh. That would help.
This pretty much sums up Kate. Shy and sweet. And in the wrong place.
Kate Marsh represents the very best of the students at Blackwell Academy. Her GPA is consistently outstanding, along with her optimistic attitude and quiet work ethic. Her extracurricular activities with Meals on Wheels program has been acknowledged by KBAY7 News, and her diverse religious studies group has been a welcome addition to the wide range of student-led spiritual programs at Blackwell. She also has one of the best attendance records in the school's history. Principal Wells, as the school nurse, I should inform you that Kate Marsh appears to have experienced some recent emotional or physical trauma. I spoke to her briefly, and she was upset but vague and refused to talk further with me. I think it's important that we keep our eyes on her and make sure she's not under duress from other classmates, as is my suspicion. Regards. Well, the nurse gave a warning. Apparently it was not heeded. At present time, there was a security investigation into a controversial video allegedly featuring Kate Marsh at a Vortex Club party that has been uploaded onto the internet without her knowledge or alleged consent, along with her claim of being taken to the hospital during the party. See the attached files for complete details.
Let's nab this last file, Sherlock. Always wanted to say nab. Looks like an oil painting spill. Awful.
An oil painting.
Looks everywhere, Max. There has to be some info in the student files.
What'd Chloe say?
So, Nathan Prescott's dad is a bully, too. Shocker.
Principal Wells, in light of the recent outrageous allegations against my son and his suspension, I feel that my large contributions to Blackwell Academy should also be suspended. Of course, this situation can be rectified once Nathan is reinstated at Blackwell with a written apology. Along with that, I understand that the tragic event involving Miss Marsh gives you pause, but I would suggest that canceling Thursday's party is not conducive to the can-do spirit of Blackwell Academy. I expect you to reconsider and come to the same obvious conclusion. Thank you, Sean Prescott.
Tumbleweeds. Look at this pile.
I think I know where the other file is.
That is so cool that my signature actually counted. Go, Miss Grant.
Dear Miss Grant, as principal of Blackwell Academy, it is my... What'd he write? Glad, happy, fortunate duty? I don't know what it says. To inform you that your petition to block the installation of a new surveillance system has received enough signatures for the school to reject the plan. It is not my policy to take sides in these matters, as we encourage the faculty and student body to participate in their school's operation. However, I did recognize the controversial nature of these cameras and shared your concern for possible invasions of privacy. Thank you for your passion and for inspiring Blackwell students to make their voices heard. I hope they will feel empowered by the outcome of your petition. Best, Principal Wells. I guess this still has to be written up by typed up by the secretary or something. Alright, so we must be in here. Student files.
Weird. This asshole has a spotless record.
Nathan Joshua Prescott. 3.7 GPA. Nathan Prescott continues his family's historical legacy at Blackwell Academy with a stellar academic record and a variety of extracurricular activities, including work with the Arcadia Bay Homeless Fund. Nathan is also popular with students and faculty. He stands as a proud representation of Blackwell.
Like I'm not going to read my own personal file.
Oh, wow. 2.8 GPA? How do we mess up so bad? What's the actual date of birth here? Work phone. Max, as she prefers to be called, is considered a quiet, attentive student with much potential for her photography. Her GPA fluctuates, and she has acknowledged she should be doing better. Her teachers look Her teachers back up her quiet intelligence, though some complaints find her too nervous and nosy. With taking pictures. Some faculty members would like Max to speak up more in class and be more assertive. Others would like her to be less so. But this is a common student suggestion rather than a specific recommendation. Update. Despite some recent confrontations with Blackwell security, Max tried to unsuccessfully stop fellow student Kate Marsh from jumping off the dormitory roof to her death today. At this time, there was an ongoing police and faculty investigation, but Max's bravery is indisputed. That's right, biatches.
This file is going to be so spotless, I'll projectile vomit.
Victoria Chase is the gold standard for Blackwell Academy, a student with a consistently high GPA and extracurricular activities that reflect her career goals in photography. Victoria also receives high marks from faculty for her devotion to the Vortex Club, among other organizations devoted to Blackwell spirit and history.
I have to make sure Warren doesn't have a criminal background.
Mm-hmm. Warren Daniel? Is that what that says? Or Daryl? Can't make it out. 4.0 GPA, oh my god. Warren is considered an exemplary student and represents a long tradition of excellence in science at Blackwell. He has the gift or curse of gab, depending on the faculty. Some have accused him of playing science pranks, but this is not confirmed by his science teacher, Ms. Grant. We hope Warren focuses his academic vision and continues towards his bright future.
I think we found everything in here. I should go join Chloe now.
Let me first look at this painting.
This should be hanging in a thrift store.
All right. Nothing else to see, right? Taking a scenic tour.
Max, you better come check out these files.
Here
Nathan accuses Rachel of bringing drugs on campus, and my step troll went along because he thinks Rachel was a bad influence on me. Assholes.
If David is teaming up with Nathan Prescott, that's a bad sign.
Nathan Prescott III. Ooh, he's so money. And you know the Prescotts dropped major bank to bury Nathan's real file. Look, it reads like a rap sheet. Bad grades, teacher complaints, secret probation. But I was expelled?
At least Nathan was finally suspended. Check out that note. Open it.
It's just some crazy drawing.
It's not a drawing. Look. Rachel in the dark room. Rachel in the dark room.
What?
Over and over. That's it.
That's fucked up. What does this even mean? Nathan is truly psychotic. I know he has something to do with Rachel missing.
Whoa. Listen to this. David M. always asks what's going on in my head. David M. always helps me follow those he follows. It's pretty cryptic.
No, it sounds like they formed some sort of weird team, the Super Hebros.
Jesus. David was stalking Kate, hassling me, and now we know he was all over Rachel, too.
Oh, we are so going into his garage files. Plus, I'm getting a little paranoid in here. We got our info, let's bail. But maybe we shouldn't leave without a gift.
A no, gift? You are not taking the cozy chair.
Max, do your powers include mind reading? Or did you just rewind because I tried to steal the chair? Shit, I'm confused.
It's the powers of best friendship. I know how you roll. We should definitely get out of here. We pressed our luck enough.
Hello, what have we here?
What's that there? Handicapped?
Holy shit! Jackpot! Cha-ching!
Wow, sir. That's a lot for the handicapped fund.
Dude, there's $5,000 here. I could pay Frank back tonight. This'll chill him out after our knife showdown yesterday.
Can't do that.
Are you gonna make a big issue out of this?
Yeah.
Or just rewind and take the greenbacks for yourself?
No.
I hope you do that instead of lecturing me.
Look at steal money for handicapped people. What the hell is the matter with you?
You really want to take money from the handicapped fund? I know you need to pay Frank back, but I've got my power to protect you, right?
There's a lot of power in that horse-choking wad of cash. But yes,
Moral Max is right again. I guess. Let's get the hell out of this office, Morg.
Watch, Chloe dies as a result of me not taking the money from the handicap fund.
You know that money would have helped Chloe and me.
Look at this picture. Disciplinary warning report. Dear Mr. and Mrs. Prescott, we regret to inform you that Nathan Prescott has disrupted various classes over the past month despite repeated warnings and leniency due to a crude outburst in Mrs. Hoyda's Intro to Literature class on Tuesday, September 17th. Nathan was sent back to his dormitory for the day without a proper write-up for his files. Excuse me, Nathan has enormous potential but also erratic behavior patterns that may need supervision beyond Blackwell's ability. The school cannot tolerate these disruptions, so we hope you will discuss the matter with Nathan to impress upon him the severity of this situation. Please see the attached files for full reports. Update. Expunged record. Dear Principal Wells, we received a letter, a rather outrageous and possibly slanderous letter from somebody in administration accusing Nathan of uncharacteristic erratic behavior patterns. We're certain this must be a mistake, otherwise we fear that we will take Nathan out of Blackwell to a more prestigious and better funded institution. Please respond with a copy of the expunged disciplinary warning report. Blackwell Incident Report, Nathan Prescott. The following is a list of reported incidents involving Nathan Prescott. There seems to be a pattern of outbursts and confrontations, followed by remorse and repentance. We suggest his parents remove him from the school and place him under expert psychological supervision. Throwing a desk in class, cursing at his English teacher, lighting firecrackers in the bathroom, stealing school supplies, threatening the school custodian, attempted theft of Canvas Tobanga statue. Oh my god. And then what he wrote here. Rachel is in the dark room. You're right. All work and no play makes Nathan a lonely boy. David Mattson and Nathan Prescott have both come to my office to warn me that Rachel Amber has been a drug mule in Mr. Madsen's talk radio terminology, acting as a front for another local dealer. Considering Rachel's exemplary status, I told David that I would need more concrete proof, and he promised that he had more to show. I was surprised to get an unscheduled visit from Rachel Amber. She seemed quite upset and claimed that David Mattson was following her and taking photographs. David would deny this, and given the questionable company Rachel has been keeping, I'm not certain I can believe her right now. Oh, meaning Chloe? My god. I looked at all that stuff. Can't turn a lamp on now. Does the lights outside, right? Not lights, headlights of a car. Made me nervous.
That impish look scares me.
Mm-hmm.
Care for a midnight swim? The Blackwell pool is ours.
Swimming?
You want to take that risk now?
Skinny dipping.
It's been a cray week. You didn't let me take that money to pay off Frank, so if he pops a cap in my skull, at least allow me to have a little carefree fun for a few minutes.
Oh god.
Splish splash?
You're right. We hella deserve it. Splish splash.
Did you actually just say hella? I think I'm a good bad influence on you.